When the global COVID-19 pandemic was declared in March, there was no telling how long the crisis would last. Now into the fourth month, with over 4.3 million COVID-19 infections in the United States, many people are realizing that the pandemic is more of a marathon than a sprint. In fact, I don't really see us eradicating it, White House coronavirus advisor Dr. Anthony Fauci said of the virus on July 22. Though that doesn't mean Americans will always have to live with strict restrictions once there are treatments or a vaccine, accepting that we do have to live with a new normal for the foreseeable future is no easy task, says Andrea Bonnier, a licensed clinical psychologist and author of Detox Your Thoughts, who is on the faculty at Georgetown University. Most of us are coping with higher levels of anxiety and chronic stress as a result of living with the threat of a deadly viral illness, Bonnier says. The uncertainty makes it even worse because we can't tell ourselves that there is an end in sight, she says. Humans are hardwired to plan ahead and anticipate dangers, says Susan Swift, a licensed clinical psychologist with the telemedicine platform Heal. We want to have control of what's happening, Swift says. And when we don't have control, it does feel harder to get through things. Here are ways to help you stay happier and calmer as we learn to live with COVID-19 long-term. If these last months have taught us anything, it's that things can change constantly, Swift says. It does feel like this pandemic is never going to end and that can feel stressful and overwhelming, she says. But focusing on the negative aspects of the current situation is not going to make you feel calmer, she says. It's only natural to think and plan for what-if scenarios, but sometimes we end up down that rabbit hole where our thoughts are no longer based in reality, Swift says. When you notice yourself slipping into that rabbit hole, or catastrophizing your situation, recognize that it's your body's anxiety response in action. Handling what is happening right now on a daily basis will make you feel more in control, she says. It does take a lot more effort to challenge and reframe those anxious thoughts, Swift says. But when we can do that, then it helps you look at the situation from a more positive and hopeful perspective. Questions like, will our kids be in school and will we need to be in an office, are still unknown for many people around the country, which makes planning for the future practically impossible. Bonnier believes that the best way to cope with this loss of control is to look at facts and stay flexible. Think about specific scenarios from an objective standpoint. For example, what are the benefits and drawbacks of returning to school? What decisions are possible and not possible for my family? Give yourself permission to take your own individual family factors into account, and extend that respect to other families.